Linda and I are going to be discussing the layout of developed versus undeveloped space in Amesbury, as well as the breakdown of private versus public land ownership. So our first map, we have the state of development in Amesbury. Once again, this data and the data for the next map was broken down by tax parcel using 2014 tax parcel data from the level 3 assessor's list off of MassGIS. And just a note on symbology, gray refers to developed parcels, green to undeveloped, and the red color is roads or parcels we couldn't account for otherwise. So as you can see, developed land makes up a majority of the tax parcels in the town of Amesbury. That said, undeveloped land is not so far behind. The breakdown is 47 to 33%, with 18% coming in as either roads or unknown properties. So just to give a sense of what is currently, or at least as of 2014, built out or has land on it, has development on it. And we're defining development as any parcel with a fixed structure or impervious surface traveling over it, a paved surface. So with regards to public and private parcels, red refers to private, with green referring to, So red refers to private land, green referring to public land, and gray referring to roads, or again, land that didn't have any data or sufficient data to conclude whether it was public. Again, that accounts for a significant minority of the land. That's, once again, about 18%, with a similar breakdown to developed and undeveloped land.
What's the percent on public?
So public land is actually, I was wrong, my apologies. So private makes up a much stronger majority, with 66% private and 14% publicly owned land. So, once again, note on definitions, we define private as any land that is not owned either by the town of Amesbury or by another government entity, public obviously being the reverse. So that's all that I have, so I'll open the floor to questions.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
So the pink land that you're showing is private. This isn't an overlay of the open space versus development.
No,
it's two
no.
Separate, completely distinct.
Sorry, yeah, they're separate, similar layout, but different maps.
So you could have public development.
Yes, absolutely. So public and private does not necessarily link, I should say, to state of development. These are two separate maps making two separate observations.
Very similar to also thinking about development land, as you said, anything that has impervious structure or a structure is considered developed in there. So even if it's farmland, so to speak, 61A, but it has a barn on that property, then that they have included as developed land. So I think that you have to be cognizant of the fact developed doesn't necessarily mean it's developed as we think it to be. It could be still protected under 61A and 61B.
wanted to know what was paved over, we would call it pervious or impervious surfaces. And we actually have that data too. We didn't bring that here to present. But we can actually distinguish at a fine level what's been paved over. So the succeeding maps will actually start to overlay more detail so you can see kind of the combined categories of those things as well. And we also brought with us the documentation that explains in detail exactly what goes into each of these layers and how we define these categories. So you can look at it in more detail. And I would say too, this is something to think about how you want to group these things, how you want to call them when you're thinking about what constitutes open space or usable land in an open space context.
So just a point on that, the way we look at open space is anything that's permanently protected. Because then it's open space, otherwise it's just undeveloped, so to speak, vacant land. So I think that data is very helpful if you know, which is typically what we do in a master plan, you know, what is undeveloped and protected, or open and protected. So those categories then really start to speak what area of town or what portion of town can be developed, and what is the growth potential, what is the impact from that growth, and how that would then lead to other strategic policy decisions of where that growth should take place, where infrastructure should be looked at, invested, improved, or not. That's typically how we would be looking at land planning in our office. That's how we would call that. So hopefully we can use your data for that purpose.
Was all your data desktop or was anything ground truth?
So this data came from MassGIS. So it came from the desktop. We didn't fill out and do any assessments ourselves in person.
They get a lot of their personal data right from the